Cable or no cable? Wireless mice are more comfortable to use, but how does their input lag compare to wired mice? Thanks to my input lag testing machines, I can now answer this question not just for the mouse buttons, but also the mouse sensor. If you don't know how my testing methods work, then please watch the video I'll link to in the description, as I won't explain it again today to keep this video as short as possible. Okay, for today's video I tested the Razer Death Adder V2 Pro, which you can switch between wired mode, Razer's Hyperspeed 2.4 GHz wireless mode, and Bluetooth. What I'm interested in is the entire end-to-end delay, which means that I need to have a linear solenoid push the mouse button at the perfect spot, right above where the plastic extends down to the mouse switch. With the monitor's refresh rate set to 144 Hz, the LDAT display test software running at 144 fps, and the polling rate of the Razer Death Adder V2 Pro set to its maximum of 1000 Hz, I measured an average end-to-end delay of 17.62 milliseconds for the mouse click. In wireless mode using Razer's 2.4 GHz dongle, the end-to-end delay is slightly longer, and when you look at the standard deviation markers, you can see that there is also slightly more variation, which means that the delay is less stable. In Bluetooth mode, you cannot select the polling rate inside the Razer Synapse application. In that mode, the mouse seems to use a polling rate of 200 Hz, which has a very negative impact on the end-to-end delay. Now, how about the delay when you start to move your mouse from a standstill? At 1600 dpi, I measured an average end-to-end delay of 19.96 milliseconds in wired mode. With Razer's Hyperspeed wireless mode, the delays increase by about 1 millisecond. And with Bluetooth, the delays are much longer and less stable. Then, for the delay when you suddenly change the direction the mouse is moving, I measured 20.96 milliseconds on average in wired mode, 22.27 milliseconds on average with Razer's Hyperspeed wireless mode, and with Bluetooth, the delays are again much longer and far less stable. Then, with the monitor set to a refresh rate of 360 Hz, and the LDAT display test software running at 500 fps, there's only a very small difference between wired and wireless, while Bluetooth has much more lag. When it comes to the delay of mouse movement, then we see the same behavior as before at 144 Hz and 144 fps. Razer's Hyperspeed wireless mode has about 1 millisecond more delay than the wired mode, and with Bluetooth, the delays are much longer and far less stable. So, since the delay difference between the Razer Death Adder V2 Pro's wired and wireless modes is very small, it is quite unlikely that you will start to lose matches when you switch to Razer's Hyperspeed wireless mode. That said, I would avoid Bluetooth for competitive games, as in that mode the polling rate is just 200 Hz, which has a considerable impact on the end-to-end system latency. However, if your goal is to minimize the end-to-end delay of your system as much as possible, then you might want to stick with the wired mode, which does provide the lowest delays and is less likely to be affected by interference, which can be a problem for all wireless devices. And that's it for today. Let me know in the comments if you would like to see more videos like this one, where I try to keep it as short and focused as possible, while still providing the information you are interested in. I want to thank my fine patrons for their awesome support, which allowed me to come up with the test methods required for today's video. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, ring the bell to get notified when I upload my next video, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.